Dear participants, Namaskar. I hope all are doing well and staying safe. Myself, Dr. Pasalagopi, working as Associate Professor in Electrical and Electronics Engineering Department at Annamacharya Institute of Technology and Science, Andhra Pradesh. I am preparing this video for the sake of assignment under International FDP on Environment and Sustainability. Here is the details of video 1 and 2 presentations. For video 1 presentation, you can go through this YouTube link. In week 1 presentation, what I discussed are how the electricity is generated and delivered to the consumers and how it is utilized. Then, what is electricity system and what are the impacts on environment. Then, what are the environmental impacts of your energy usage and how we can reduce these environmental impacts. Then finally, how to calculate greenhouse gas equivalencies. In week 2, we discussed about the definition of ISO, need and benefits of ISO standards for energy, and what are the various standards of ISO for energy are available. With this video presentation, after learning through this video, the students will able to identify various ISO standards and the students will able to calculate carbon emission or footprints using various online sites. And also, the students can able to know how to calculate the cost unit of CFLs. Before discussing in detail, let me explain some basics about ISO. ISO means International Organization for Standardization. It is a global organization that works to provide standardization across an array of products and companies. The main goal of this ISO standard is to facilitate old trade, but it mainly focuses on process improvement, safety, and quality in several areas. The importance of ISO is to get benefits from reducing the waste, allows your workforce to be more efficient, establish ongoing quality management system standards for improvement and sustainable customer successes. So far, the ISO has published more than 21,584 standards and has members in 162 countries and 788 technical bodies for standard developments. The organization continues to record in increasing in certification in 2020. This picture shows the organization of ISO. In organization of ISO, there is a council. That council is created by policy development committees and General Assembly. This council will create Technical Management Board. From this Management Board, there is an advisory group and our technical committees. Now the question here is, how I can register for ISO? There are some stages to register your own ISO. So the first one is submit your application to registrar. Registrar will scrutinize your ISO registration by two stages. In stage 1, there is an assessment of readiness, and in stage 2, assessment for registration process. After successful completion of these two stages, the Council of ISO Standardization Organization will issue registration or certification award for 3 years. Here the question is, after 3 years, what we have to do? Before the end of 3 years, or at the end of 3rd year, you have to apply or you have to submit the application to the council for recertification. Now let us see what are the various ISO standards that are available with brief description. The first one is ISO 9000. This ISO 9000 provides quality management. In this standard, they will guide the companies and equip them with the necessary tools to continuously improving quality and ensure that customer demands are always met. There are 1 million organizations in over 170 countries that are certified to ISO 9001. Second one is ISO 14000. ISO 14000 is meant for environmental management. These standards uses tools like audits, communications, life cycle analysis, and environmental challenges. This standard can be used by any organization regardless of industry. More than 3 lakh ISO 14001 certifications have been issued in 171 countries till now. Third one is ISO 50001. It is established in 2018 and it is meant for energy management. It provides guidance for companies in implementing an energy management system that aims at improving efficiency in the use of energy. Over 20,000 certifications has been issued for this standard, with a 69% increase from 2015. Then fourth standard is ISO or IEC 27000. It is meant for information security and management system. It is at fore of global attention with a rapid increase in cyber threats. These standards ensures the safety of information assets. There are 33,290 certificates issued for this certification. Next one is ISO 26000. It is developed in 2010 and it is meant for social responsibility. This standard provides guidance on how organization can embrace social responsibility. Next one is ISO 22000. It is developed for food management system. This standard facilitates the development and implementation of food safety management system. So far, more than 30,000 of certificates have been issued. Now let us see how to calculate carbon emission or footprint. Before calculating, let us see first what is carbon footprint. Carbon footprint means it is the amount of greenhouse gases produced by a particular human activity. The graph shows the percentage CO2 emission by the old population by income. From the graph, it is clear that 10% of richest people in the world are responsible for generation of almost half of CO2 emission, but only 50% of poor peoples are responsible for generation of 10% of CO2 emission. The calculation of CO2 and other greenhouse gas emissions that you are responsible for over a 12 months period is very important as an individual. There are some steps for calculation of CO2 emission manually. Those are, in first step, first we have to estimate the total kilowatt hour of our house There are number of online sites that are available for estimation of CO2 and other greenhouse gas emissions. So, sir, TataPower.com. It is already discussed in the first week assignment of this international FBB. Now, I would like to explain how to calculate the CO2 and other greenhouse gas emissions using remaining two online sites. So for this, just you click on www.carbonindependent.org. It shows a window like this. It consists of two sections. In each section, you have to give some information to the questions in both sections. In section one, you have to enter your household data like heating, car usage, etc. In section two, you have to enter your personal lifestyle, that is traveling choices that are applied to you as an individual. When you enter this full data, it shows a chart like this. I prepared this one for my personal sake only on 28 May 2020. Like this, you can calculate the carbon footprint using this site. And one more site for calculation of this CO emission or footprint is myclimate.org. When you click on this myclimate.org, it shows a video like this. Since we are calculating the footprint, so that you have to click the footprint symbol like this, which is shown here. Here also it asks seven questions that are related to your personal as well as household. After answering all seven questions, click on continue button, which is placed at bottom of right side bottom of this window. When you press this button, it shows result as shown in below figure. Here one interesting point I have to claim that the footprint which is generated by me or which is calculated by me in both side using both sites is same. That is, in first site it is 6.52 tons per year, and in second site also my CO2 emission is 6.6 tons per year. Now let us see the sustainability competition. Here I am considering compact fluorescent lamp as a case study. These CFLs uses less energy and last longer than incandescent lamp. They save you money in long run, and they are better for environment. Yes, at today's average electricity rate, you can expect a FL plus CFL bulb to save you about ₹3,250 in energy saving before it burns out. The question here is, are CFLs really good for environment? Answer is yes, because when you compare with the switching of single 100 watts incandescent lamp, a CFL bulb can produce much lighting and uses only 1/4 of total energy. So by using energy use calculator, you can calculate the cost per house or cost per day or cost per month or cost per year of each and every bulb. Here I am showing some examples for CFLs or the comparison for CFLs and conventional incandescent lamp. When you compare with conventional incandescent lamp, the power consumption by using CFL is very low. That is, it consumes only 0.07 kWh per a day, but whereas incandescent lamp may consume 0.3 kWh per a day. And finally, the CFLs also have much longer life than conventional incandescent lamp. That is, the life of CFLs is 900 hours with life guarantee, but the conventional incandescent lamp may have only 1000 hours, but there is no guarantee of its life.